Power overload. Mzvee, Will is beats.
Why say?
Swag.
You hit the jackpot bingo. Hope you bigger than your ego. A, B, C, let the D go. You go, B go.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys all doing? You guys, you know one thing I love about being a woman and being able to have hair and do all those fancy hairstyles, because you can change your hairstyle anytime you want. You can look different depending on your mood. You can just, you know, decide to have long hair today, tomorrow decide to have short hair, today decide to have kinky blown out, more relaxed hair look, you know, like what else can be better than that? So today's video, I'm going to be trying out this kinky blowout wig that most of you actually thought it was my natural hair. When I posted this picture on my Instagram, someone was like, I thought did your hair grow? I mean, I just saw your last video, like, what happened? Like, girl, no. Like, my hair couldn't have grown this long overnight. Like, if people's hair grew this long overnight, then what more can we ask for in life? That would be a great miracle, you know? But no, it wasn't my hair. It's actually a wig. So I'm going to show you guys how I actually installed this wig, and I actually styled it into this very cute two-bun look, half up, half down sort of hairstyle. So I was actually trying out the bald cap method. I'm not a perfectionist when it comes to installing wigs. Like, I feel like every time I try this, I keep learning, I keep trying to grow more, I keep, you know, learning new tricks and tips and how to, you know, make my wig look perfect. But you know, I just kept trying, and this is what I actually came up with. So it's not as perfect as I would have loved. I'm just gonna take you guys through the entire process and things that I wish I had done differently. So I'm going to be using this tan airbrush leg spray in the color medium. I honestly wish I got the shade darker, like this color tan, because I wanted something that would look more natural. This is kind of like a little bit too light, and I realized after I had opened it and sprayed it on my hair, I was like, damn, this shit is light. Like, what the heck? And although yes, your scalp is supposed to be like one shade lighter than your actual skin tone, but I feel like this was way, way too light. Like, it was just too light. But yeah, so the hair I'll be using in this video is from Dolago Hair Company, and then they sent me this hair. It comes with a wig cap, and this is what the wig looks like. It also comes with an extra strap, like you guys already saw. So I'll just go ahead to open this wig. This is what it looks like in the most natural look ever possible. I mean, the lace looks pretty good. It also comes with a strap that looks like a bra strap that you can use to adjust this wig if your head is pretty small. So I actually love the look, and I was like, damn, like, this is what I'm here for. And this wig is in the length 12 inches. Yeah, 12 inches, so it's more like a short bob cut wig. I also went ahead to put the spray tan on the lace of this wig as well, just so it could blend with the bowl cap I had on my head. So I'll go ahead to use my Got To Be glue gel and just put it on the perimeter of my forehead and just use that to seal this lace onto my hair. First of all, I'll go ahead to blow dry this Got To Be glue gel just so it could be tacky, and when it's tacky, it makes it a lot easier to just hold the lace onto my head and just, you know, for it to just stay in place perfectly. So after sealing this down onto my forehead perimeter, I'll just go ahead to hold this, and then I'll go back again with the blow dryer just to dry this down and make sure it's properly secure to my head. So now I'll go ahead to use my scissors to actually cut out this lace after I'm done gluing it down. Not gluing it down though, but holding it down to my hairline. Per se, I didn't really want any baby hair. I just wanted something that looks natural. Like, sometimes it just don't really feel like the baby hair. So I just, like, yeah, I don't think I feel like baby hair today. I just want everything to be out of my face. So I went ahead to cut out this lace according to my hairline. Just trim it out, take your time. And you know, like, sometimes the ear part is a little bit long for, like, most of us, especially me. So I actually normally go ahead to make sure that I take my time to cut this part just so it looks proper and nice. And then I'll just go ahead to hold down the rest of my hair using this, what's this called? I think it's a paper wrap. I don't really remember what the name is actually. But I'll find the name and put it down in the description box for you guys. I just use this to hold my hair down together while I did my makeup. A lot of you guys have actually asked me about this eye look. This is my everyday summer eye look. Like, super easy. I just normally use just two eyeshadow colors. The one bright orange color from the Juvia's Face Zulu palette. And then I normally go ahead to use this burnt orange that has a pinkish undertone color from the Modern Renaissance palette for my crease. And yeah, that's basically all I do for my eyes. It's actually very easy, more like my everyday summer look, like I said. So after doing this, I'll just go ahead to make sure that everything is well blended. And I went ahead to use my Morphe liquid black eyeliner for like the top part of my eyes, and then the Morphe eye pencil eyeliner for like the bottom part of my eyes. And I'll just go ahead to wear my false lashes, and as usual, I like to make sure that my eyeshadow is sort of balanced. So I use the same color that I use for the top, the bright orange from the Zulu palette, and I just use that to balance the bottom of my eyelid. That's basically the end of that look. I'll just go back to working on my hair. So for this hair, I just went ahead to straighten each of them, just so it could look more, you know, more like a relaxed sort of look. Like I said, I didn't want any baby hair or any of those, and I was actually going for like a side parting, because I feel like side partings look good on me sometimes, and I was just like, yes, let's do it today. So I did a side parting. I went ahead to clean any excess spray tan that I had on my hair. As you guys can see what I mean, I feel like the scalp is a little bit too light. I should have gone for like one shade higher, like that's the shade tan, but you know, it wasn't that bad. It still turned out pretty cute, and I still went ahead to use the avocado hair mousse from Curls just to lay down any flyaways from this hair. And after doing that, I was like, yes, I actually love this. This looks so natural. It was just like my type of vibe. So to give you guys a different look, I wanted to do like the half up, half down, but like with two buns in front. Just go ahead to part out the two buns for the front. And then, yeah, after parting that, I just splitted like the two halves of the bun into separate ways. And then I use these butterfly clamps just to hold one side while I work on the other. So just to work on this, it's pretty simple. All I did was to make sure, of course, first of all, that you're holding down your frontal, because you don't want this to pull when you're trying to like pull on these ponytails. You want to make sure that you're not putting so much pressure on like the front of your frontal. Like I said, I didn't use any glue. I just used the Godsby gel. So you have to be careful, you know. So for this bun, I just used water, sprayed this on the bun in front, and then went over top with the same hair mousse just to make sure everything is laid properly. Then I used my bristle brush and just brushed this up, and then used this black elastic band to actually just hold this into a nice ponytail. Yeah, that's it, honestly, like it was that simple. So I'll do the exact same thing for the other side of the ponytail, and you guys could just watch. Now that I'm done making the ponytail, I'm making sure it's secure, I'll just take it and kind of swirl it and just make that into a very nice bun. And then after making that into a nice bun, I'll go ahead to use a smaller elastic band to make sure that I hold this bun down, like you guys will see. Also use a got to be spray just to make sure that this bun actually stays in place and all the hair is properly laid the way I would like. And I went ahead, of course, I wanted something that's more of a bob look that will fit with these two ponytails in front. So I went ahead to, you know, use my straightener to just give my hair more of a bob look for the rest of the hair that I have left. And the last thing I went ahead to do was to accessorize this bun. Of course, I love me some accessories. But yeah, that's basically the end of this look. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much, and make sure you have a wonderful rest of your week and a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye. Mwah.